approximately 30 years ago, it's a long time ago, it became clear in Israel that we have severe problems in the teaching, particularly of physics, in high schools. And it was not one problem. It was not a problem of teachers only. It was not a problem of budget only. It was a basic, fundamental difficulty which was spread all over the country. And to my best knowledge, also exists in many other countries. First of all, a shortage of qualified physics teachers. Today, with the high-tech startup industries, physics teachers are even more attracted by industry than they used to be. Second, it's expensive equipment if you want to do it right. Third, you need technicians and maintenance for the equipment, which schools usually either do not have or cannot afford, or both. And then the teacher, even if there is a good teacher, is very lonely. You have a big school and there's only one teacher who is teaching advanced physics to the highest grades of school. And that teacher is alone. He has nobody to talk to about physics. The other teachers are teaching English or Hebrew or history or other fields or mathematics. And the result is a lonely teacher, often unqualified, without good equipment. And how do you solve it? And the idea was to solve it by combining the physics labs or the physics teaching rooms of all the schools of one big city into one location, where all the teachers can talk to each other, where you use the same equipment for all the schools in the same city. And that was the idea behind Chemda. We decided to try it. We approached the two largest cities in Israel, Jerusalem and Tel Aviv. The mayor of Jerusalem frowned. The mayor of Tel Aviv smiled. So we went to Tel Aviv. And we started a big project. And the rest is history. And it's quite a successful history. In order to advance the idea, we needed, first of all, a building. We needed a guaranteed operating budget for many years, for eternity, essentially. We needed to recruit the best teachers that we could get. And we have done several things which were, in a way, revolutionary, but not very sophisticated. For instance, we offered the working condition for the teachers, like in the high-tech industry, namely a relatively higher salary based not on seniority and the number of years that you are teaching, but on the quality of your work, with a review every year. And in that way, we succeeded in getting all the teachers' union against us, but good teachers to join us. There was a fight with the teachers' union for a few years, and later everything was quiet and everything was accepted. And we are succeeding even in stealing teachers from industry, because it's a different way of life. And there are many, many scientists and engineers in industry who really would like to contribute to education, and they couldn't do it in their industry work. So that was one aspect. We ended up having a very happy group of teachers, because they teach, but they spend a lot of time with each other. They can discuss any issue. If a teacher is very strong in electricity and mechanics, but doesn't know anything about astronomy, he can find another teacher that would be a guest teacher in the classroom for astronomy, etc., etc. So all of this created an atmosphere of joint collaboration, joint work of the teachers, and the children felt that this is a different way of learning physics. It's just a different world. And when you interview now the high school kids that are going there, you immediately see that there's a sparkle in their eyes. And that's really what we wanted. We started from the very beginning and we said that we want two things. We want excellent success in the matriculation and a spark in the eyes of the children. And in fact, the logo of Chemda is a square, to say that we are square, we go for the matriculation in a square way, but with stars floating inside the square to indicate the sparks that we want to see in the eyes of the children. When we started building Chemda, we knew that we need two things. A building, which means a piece of land, and the cost of the building, the construction and the equipment. So that's number one. And number two, a firm commitment for funding the operating budget of Chemda for many, many years, forever. We found philanthropic help for the building. The building was entirely built by the Rothschild Foundation, who didn't even want its name on it. That's one of the principles. But they funded 100% of the cost of the building. The city of Tel Aviv offered us a choice among five or six different locations, some of them empty lots, some of them existing old schools that were deserted, which we were invited to renovate, but we also had the option of take one of the existing old school, destroy it, and rebuild on the same empty lot, and that's what we did. So that took, and here I have to say, you have to have a totally integrated approach. We could not do what we did if the first principal of Chemda and I, as chairman of the board, and a few other people were not involved in every little detail, because an architect cannot design such a thing without understanding the concept thoroughly. The municipality didn't really know exactly what was going to be there. So it took the donor, the architect, the municipality, and the customers, namely us, to design. And it's a beautiful building, and it's a beautiful success. Now, the municipality took upon itself to finance the operating budget or to raise philanthropic donations for part of it, and they have been doing it faithfully and successfully now for about 25 years, and will continue to do it because they consider it one of the gems of education in the city of Tel Aviv. Every mayor since that time has been proud of it, and that's the way it is. Now that there is a second branch of Chemda near the Weizmann Institute, it is partly financed again by philanthropic donors and partly by the relevant municipalities. What has to be understood is that the municipalities are not giving net financing to this because they are also saving money by not teaching physics in 20 different schools and by building 20 physics labs and hiring 20 teachers and 20 technicians. So the money of maintenance or operation is largely a replacement of money spent anyway, and not even necessarily more because of the saving on the equipment and the laboratories. So that's the system basically. Here and there there's additional philanthropy, here and there there's an additional gift, but by and large, whoever finances the school system, whether it's the federal government in some European government or the regional government or the city government. In Israel, it's the Ministry of Education through the municipality has to finance also such a center. When we establish a system where the teachers are rewarded according to achievement, quality, not so much age and seniority, and they have contracts which allow termination of contract. We had problems with the unions. We also had a few situations, very few, where an existing physics teacher of one of the high schools that joined Chemda had to be demoted to teach instead of the age 15 to 18 children, only the age 12 to 15, because the 15 to 18 age group went to Chemda. So all of this was really casus belli with the teachers' union. What we did, we didn't try to convince them. What we did is we tried to show that what we do is to the benefit of our teachers, to the benefit of the children, to the benefit of the parents that were very happy with it from the very beginning. And we were very careful when the school started joining Chemda. When we started, nobody forced any school to join. We started with two or three schools that came, and then there were five, and then there were seven, and now all the schools of Tel Aviv except one. There's one school that considered itself so good that they don't need such gimmicks, I'm quoting. And so now all the schools of Tel Aviv, except one, are in Chemda. And schools, for instance, that had a 60-year-old good teacher decided to wait until the teacher will retire and joined 5 years later, and so on. So it was step by step, smooth, slow, but it is now quite a number of years that there's absolutely no problem and no conflict at all.